What is up, you guys? You're watching Sergio's Secret. Before I get started with today's video, this video is in collaboration with Farfetch, and I want to say thank you much to Farfetch for working with me on this video. And today we are going to be doing some new and in designer. So we have some handbags and some pieces of ready to wear. I'm very, very excited to show you all the items because I'm literally quite obsessed with everything, and a lot of these items I already had on my wish list. So I was like, you know what, let's go ahead and do it. And I knocked down things that I've been wanting to get for such a long time. I believe I do have a discount with Farfetch. I believe it's 10% off. I'll leave the coupon code here, and I'll leave all the great information down in the description box. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna probably show you my favorite item. And the favorite item this year, and I cannot believe I have bought 3 versions of this bag this year. So it goes to show that this has been such a most useful, one of my favorite items to have. And as you can see, it's kind of peeping right now. It is from Marc Jacobs, and it is the Marc Jacobs. And let's go ahead and open this little gay fantasy up. Get the blue, beautiful little ribbon, the black dust bag. Let's open it, voila. And Marc Jacobs has been a brand that I have purchased quite a bit. This year, as far as handbags, I think I purchased more Marc Jacobs handbags than Tory Burch, and that's actually quite insane considering how much I talk about Tory Burch on this channel. And I do talk about Marc Jacobs, but not in a sense where it's like a full like Tory Burch. And the bag that I got is this famous handbag that's been on everybody's TikTok ad. I've literally, when I showed this to all my friends, they're like, is that the bag that I always see on ad on TikTok? And it is. So I kind of saw it and I was like, you know what, I really, really like it. I've always kind of been in the theme of those kind of fun seasonal bags. So the other one that I have that's kind of like in that fun seasonal, so we all know kind of like Sherpa bags are very in, or kind of like these fuzzy bags. And so I got this one for my birthday, and it's so cute. It's teddy style, and I quite love it. And I've been wearing it since I purchased it. And this is also considered a tote bag. I also have my Telfar X UGG Australia collaboration, and it's also kind of like that kind of furry kind of material. And so for me, I was like, you know what, another one will not hurt. And I feel like I've been loving this little kind of fur trend. I know it's not like super classic and super kind of like elegant or like timeless or classic, kind of like more of my style, but I like it because it kind of makes it a little bit more youthful. I find that sometimes I dress maybe a little too mature for my age. And so I like something that kind of like breaks that down. It kind of makes it a little bit more fun, because I feel like sometimes I just literally wear a black blazer, white t-shirt underneath, black trousers and some loafers. And so something like this kind of like instantly kind of makes the entire outfit, or kind of gives it kind of a conversation starter. And definitely these two bags have definitely given me conversation starters. So I was like, you know what, I want kind of like a black fuzzy one, and I decided to get this one. So this one is in the mini size. What I like about this tote bag versus some of the other ones, so I also have it in a denim color, and with the denim color, it's nice and it has structure, but it's, as you can see, this one has a little, it's gonna hold its structure a little bit better just because of the way this handbag is made. So this is kind of more of a patent leather, and as you can see, it's more of a crinkled leather. So I feel like patent crinkled leather has always reminded me more of Christmassy and more holidays, because 10 years ago when Coach Poppy bags were in, I remember my dad taking me and my brother to Dillard's to buy my mom a Coach Poppy bag, and I remember it was red, it was a tote, it was in canvas, and I remember that the red pattern was kind of like this crinkly version. And so ever since then, I kind of associate that with more kind of like holiday bags. And so this one has the Sherpa throughout the entire bag. And at first I thought I was gonna be a little worried about the wear and tear of the bag, considering that this is white fuzziness, but I noticed that I'm not really going to have that issue. I will say I wish that we maybe would have stopped it here, so it all would have been flat. So I will be careful where I set the bag down just because of here. But other than that, the bag's going to be perfectly fine. But honestly, it's to the place, to the car, to the car, to the place. This is a bag that I can set on the counter. And oh, another thing that I used to do a lot, which I'm going to do for this bag. So I have the dust bag, right? So you can always put the dust bag inside your handbag. And this is a tip and trick that people do to preserve their handbags. So let's say you're going to a restaurant, just pull out the dust bag and then just set it on there. And that could be you set it on the floor, or that can be you set it kind of like on the counter or a chair next to you, or maybe get a purse hook. But a word of advice for just any handbag in general is, if your dust bag does fit in the bag. So this one's a mini tote, but it's quite big or quite spacious. And always using your dust bag is always a really great idea to kind of set it down. So if you don't, if you kind of want to preserve the longevity, especially at the bottom, that's something that I do, especially with newer bags. I tend to do that a little bit. And so this one has like a little snap closure here. So it has like the snap magnetic, so it kind of makes it a little bit more concealed. And like I said, it's patent leather, and you go ahead and then you also have a strap. So not only can I carry this top handle, the crook of my arm, I can also carry this as a crossbody and shoulder bag. So it's going to be such a versatile bag. And like I said, I've already been using my denim one, and I've always been using my fuzzy ones the moment that I got them. And I get so many compliments on this because I have a pair of matching kind of similar denim that has kind of different denim patchworks. So something like this has always been working with me. And so when I saw this one and I saw all over TikTok, I was like, you know what? I actually quite like it. I think it's quite cute. And like I said, since I kind of dress a little bit more serious sometimes, I'm trying to have a little bit more fun. I find that something this kind of breaks it down and kind of makes it look a little bit more fun and a little bit more youthful. So I quite like it. I prefer the mini size out of all the sizes. I know they have like larger ones, but I think the mini size is what works for me because I either like smaller bags or I really want big bags. And I think I'm starting to really get away from that very in-between size. But this is a perfect bag. It's gonna fit your water bottle. It's gonna fit everything that needs to get fit. And I mean, like I said, this one fits everything. I've had no issues with it. And so therefore, when I decided to get this one, I was just like, you know what? Miss thing, I'm gonna go ahead and purchase this one because this one is gonna work with me quite well, and I'm gonna get so much wear on it. So the mini tote by Marc Jacobs, the tote bag and the mini size, has definitely been a win, and it's so versatile. Even though it is kind of fun and novelty, at the end of the day, it is versatile. A crossbody, shoulder bag, top handle, crook of your arm, great size. And this is kind of a conversation starter, or maybe if you don't like colored bags but you want something that has kind of a pop of something, I think this is a really great option. So the tote bag by Marc Jacobs is definitely a win in my book. The next item, guys, that I want to show you, it is a new brand on my channel. I have never talked about this brand ever on my channel, so I'm very excited to talk about. I told you guys in 2022 I definitely want to get into introducing more handbag brands that I don't have. So I'm in Dooneyburg and more other brands. And so for me, that's why I felt like adding more brands to kind of have more creativity and get out the box would be great. And I saw Lori Harvey have this bag, and when I saw Lori Harvey have this bag, I was like, wait, what is this bag? And I'll insert the picture of it here. I believe she was going to Nobu, or she was in LA, and I said, well, anything that Lori Harvey kind of has, I think she looks quite well in anything. She could literally wear a trash bag and she will look phenomenal. I do really like Lori Harvey's style, so when I saw her have this bag, I was like, this is a bag that I think is so interesting. It's so me, because it's very like, it's a black, because I got it in black, but it like, it's so different. So Koperni, I know I kind of mispronounce these names. I know last video with Farfetch, I said Totem as Tote Me, I know, but I call it Totem now, I pronounce it right. So Koperni, I believe that's what it's called. And this bag came all the way from Italy. And without further ado, here is the handbag right here. And isn't this the cutest thing ever? First of all, there's not even reviews on this on YouTube. I have not seen no more than 5 content creators that speak English talk about it, because I saw some videos but they were in other languages that I couldn't understand. So I decided, you know what, this hasn't been talked about on YouTube. Lori Harvey has it. I quite like the bag. It's phenomenally well, and I said, you know what, I'm gonna go ahead and go for it. So look at this. This is quite interesting. And then I also saw that Nordstrom and Essence and a lot of other places carry this brand. So this brand is from Paris. It's a Parisian brand, and I was kind of looking at the history of the brand. They have quite nice ready to wear. I know Bergdorf Goodman carries their ready to wear as far as like a storefront here in the States. So when I saw this bag, I was like, you know what, I am gonna go ahead and get it. I think it is so cute, and I think it's gonna be something different, because when you look behind me, and these are just some of my few bags, you have kind of like black classic YSL, classic Givenchy, classic Prada, and not saying that this is a classic, but I can go to basically any premium mall and I can find most of these bags. But I have yet to see a storefront where they even carry this, and I have yet to see have this bag. Even before I purchased it, I already kind of had in my mind like maybe a month before, and I was kind of like looking around, and I don't even see this bag a whole lot on social media. I see this more with kind of like more European girls and more kind of Asian girls. I kind of see them kind of rock this bag, but I've yet to see a lot of people in the States or kind of in Northern America carry this bag or kind of use this bag. So I was like, you know what, it's different, it's nice, it's a conversation starter. I've already used this bag 2 times, and I kid you not, I've already gotten so many compliments like, this is a cute Easter egg, this is a cute bag, this is different. And so that's why I went for it. And I think my style is always going to be kind of clean cut classic, but I kind of want to get into that stage where it's a little bit more elevated. So kind of like, it's a classic tote from Marc Jacobs, but it's an elevated, it's a little bit of a step up. This is a black mini bag, but it's kind of like a step up than what you already see. So for me, I think that's the direction where my style is going. It's just, it's continually elevating, but I find that now, especially in going into 2022, the style, you're gonna start seeing me get away with a lot more mega brands and kind of also go into smaller brands and even brands that you see on Etsy. I think that's what I kind of want to prioritize in 2022. I will always love my Burberry's, I will always love my YSL's and my Givenchy's and my Gucci's, my Tory's, but I kind of want to get into smaller brands as well, because there's so much greatness out in this entire world. So I kind of want to bring it into light with you guys. And so Caperni, I love. So it has this beautiful circle, and as far as the zippers on the side, so there's a zipper throughout the entire bag, but the zipper can literally go all the way. So if I open it up, like as you can see, the zipper can literally open, like the bag, guys, like literally, guys, can open all through the side. Not sure why you need to open it on the side. I think it's more for aesthetic purposes, but you can open it quite through, and you can put both of the zippers on the other side, and the zippers are nice and smooth, they're not gonna jam, and you can have them both open like that. And but obviously you have these little things right here. Obviously you still have the zipper, so you can't really fully open it, but just go all the way around, you open it up, and you put them kind of towards the middle, and that's the opening of the bag. And the way you open it here, I'll kind of give you a side angle, you kind of like pop the leather open, and you can kind of pop it open here as well, and that's how you kind of get in and out the bag. And then this came with a tag, which I thought was quite interesting. So it says Caperni supports one laptop per child by sponsoring a class of children with technology necessary for their education. OLPC's mission is to empower the world's children by providing each child with a connected laptop. So I'm assuming when you purchase this handbag, they give a laptop to a child. So I thought that was pretty nice. I thought that was kind of like a diff or kind of like a Tom's, where they kind of support outside of this handbag purchase. I do quite like that. It says Caperni, made in Italy. And then on the inside, it is lined with leather. And I actually quite like that it's lined with leather, because sometimes fabric on smaller bags can get kind of messy and dirty, especially if you're putting things in and out. But the opening of the bag is really not that bad, and you can actually fit quite a bit of stuff. I will say this will not fit your phone, but the beautiful thing about this is that they make them in so many different sizes. They have so many other larger sizes, so if you do want a size that fits your phone, you definitely can. But I went to the intentions of purchasing this bag to carry as a top handle, and for me, I always have my phone in my hand or my trousers, or I have it inside of a coat. And I don't really, in general, I don't like to put my phone in my bag. I just always like to have it on me on site. I even with my bigger totes, I always put it in my pocket. But this one definitely fits a card case, it definitely fits a lip balm, your AirPods, your keys, definitely fits quite a lot. And as far as the leather, it is more of the smoother leather, but as I've been using it, and you know, I'm not really careful with my bags, I let them live their life, and it's been holding up pretty well. It kind of reminds me of the Troy Burch Eleanor leather, where it's kind of like soft, but it's a little bit more, a little scratch resistant. So I know that this is gonna hold up quite well to have this bag into my collection. And I'll talk about more about this handbag later on in other videos, because I know you guys are gonna ask me a lot more questions. But Caperni, a Parisian brand, something new, something different than some of my other brands that I talk a lot about. And I'm very, very excited for this. And this is going to get so much wear. It's just like a fun take on a bag. And it's also silver hardware. You guys always know I will always prefer silver hardware than gold, even though I love gold a whole lot. But Caperni bag, I'm so excited for it, and I cannot wait to style this and get so much wear on it. So this is going to go with quite everything. So this is the second handbag. Next item that I'm going to show you guys, it is a wishlist item. If you guys saw my wishlist video that I did in November, I talked about how I wanted to add a Nanina Bean sweatshirt into my collection. I already have a white one, but it's just like a simple one that just says AB on it. I wanted to add another one that was going to kind of make it pop and that was going to kind of elevate any kind of casual. I don't know about you guys, every time I see an Anina Bing sweatshirt, I always give it compliments. I'm always here for an Anina Bing moment. I have quite a bit of Anina Bing ready to wear. I remember when I worked at Nordstrom, Dallas was one of the few stores I got Anina Bing ready to wear, and I would always love to go during my lunch hour and like try on the jeans and stuff, the jackets, the coats, the sweaters, the sweatpants, everything. And so for me, Anina Bing has always been a brand that I love. And so one of the items that I got is this Anina Bing sweatshirt, and this one is the Paris version. They have so many versions of this. And one thing I like about Farfetch is that they have so much variety in things. Like this one, they have it in crystals, they have it in so many colors, different sizes, different shapes. They have almost every tote bag that you see that's ever existed. It has been on Farfetch or will be on Farfetch or currently is on Farfetch. So I like that the variety of everything is there and the shipping tends to be pretty fast. I got this like literally within like 2 or 3 days of me ordering it, especially here in the holiday busy moment. And so this one says Paris. It has Anina Bing. This one's kind of like an off charcoal gray color, and I took it in a size small. So these tend to run a little bit oversized. In the past, I have gotten like larges. I believe my white one's a medium, but I will say I prefer the small one because they do kind of give a little bit. And so this is perfect layering with leggings, with black denim, with trousers. You can dress it up, you can dress it down, you can put, especially if you get the smaller sizes, especially if they're not super oversized, you can always put a fitted white collar underneath it and kind of give it more of a preppy kind of casual look. And so I went for it, and I quite like it. And for me, Anina Bing sweatshirts are always worth the money. I know that they're a little bit on the pricey side, but this is something that I feel like you consistently wear. And for me, if a price point is reasonable but I'm going to get the wear on it, I will buy it. So for me, I'm always been about quality versus quantity. You guys already know that I prefer to have one nice thing than to have 50 million random things. So for me, if I see the value in it and I know I'm not going to get my money's worth, I'm definitely going to purchase it. And this I've been kind of lounging around with, kind of like playing around with it, and I quite like it. And I kind of want to get the one that says London next. But they have so many different cities, they have so many different colors, size and shapes, as far as a sweatshirt collection. And then I also like their t-shirts as well. I have a few of those in my collection. So the Anina Bing Paris sweatshirt is definitely going to be a win in my book, and definitely something that is going to get so much wear inside my wardrobe. So this was a really great purchase because it's something that I'm going to wear again and again and again, and not even after the season. This is something that I can wear year round. I always kind of prefer to wear long. Fun fact about me, I'm kind of like a little insecure about wearing like just wearing t-shirts. So for me, I always prefer my t-shirts to either be a third quarter or a full sleeve. You rarely see me out with wearing just regular t-shirts without a jacket or a blazer, but something like this t-shirt or this sweatshirt that's a little bit on the longer, I can wear by itself, and that's something that I like a little bit better, because I typically don't wear regular t-shirts just out and about. I always like to for it to either be a third quarter, a full sleeve, or maybe a short sleeve but wear a jacket over it. So it's gonna go well with a lot of my vests, and it's gonna be paired really quite well. So you're gonna see me style this throughout the next couple of months. So Anina Bing Paris sweatshirt is definitely going to be a yes in my book. Then guys, the last item, which is something that I've always wanted for such a long time, and it is from Totem. So for me, one of my biggest fashion inspirations, you guys know that Lori Harvey's one of them, but probably my number one style inspiration is something that I will literally buy if she has it on. It's going to be anything that Rosie Huntington-Whiteley has. She is like the style icon. I love her style, I love her taste. And so any and everything that she has, I kind of want to have. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you guys. So a brand that she's been wearing is called Totem. I've heard about it probably last year, and I really didn't get a chance to buy anything from Totem. I only have a cap that I got a couple months back that I left at a hotel, and then luckily I was able to get it back. But I ended up getting my dream coat. So last year I saw Rosie Huntington-Whiteley have this beautiful coat, and it was from Totem, and it was quite pricey, and I always told myself, you know what, I really want the coat, I really, really, really want the coat. And so I couldn't really afford to buy it, or was it within my budget to buy it? And so I ended up going to Target and I literally saw like just a quilted jacket that was like $60, and I said, you know what, I'm just gonna go ahead and go for it. But in the back of my mind, every time that I wore them, I said, I'm gonna get the totem jacket, I'm going to get it. And so whenever I moved from Dallas from here, my friend was like, oh, what's this coat, the quilted one that was in my closet? And I was like, oh girl, you can have it. I said, I don't know, somewhere somehow I'm gonna get the totem one this year. And she was like, okay girly. I said, you get your little totem jacket. So now I have the totem jacket a full year later, and I'm so excited to have it. And I've been like literally been in my closet. I've literally been around my apartment just like trying different outfits, like just like feeling myself, feeling my fantasy with the little jackets, trying all my bags with them, like what works with it. And I'm so excited to have it. So first of all, this came all the way from the UK, and this came in a dust bag. So here is a dust bag right here. And so it's great to have a little bit of a garment dust bag. It's a little bit different because normally it would be like a hanger, but I actually quite like it because this makes it a little bit more easier to store, because I find that this jacket can be stored easily in a pouch. So I have this like that. And the jacket that I got is the classic quilted coat, and it is absolutely humongous. It is absolutely huge. It is so oversized, but nonetheless, it's quite beautiful. So one of the things that I quite like about it, and I'll actually insert videos of me wearing the jacket because I actually did a little bit of a try on and you saw that I was wearing this. One thing that I like about is that the sleeve isn't too long. The sleeve kind of stops a little bit. It's not oversized. It doesn't cover my full arm. And I'm somebody that I prefer to it kind of cut a little bit, maybe before or after my watch, but not super long. I like that it's a little bit on the oversized fit. I took in a size small and I was gonna get a size medium, and thank God that I listened to my instincts, and you should always listen to your instincts. I ended up taking it in a size small, just because for me, I don't have any breasts. And then something when I worked at Nordstrom, they would always tell me is like, for a woman's coat, for you, you actually want to size down, because sometimes most coats have extra fabric, and that's why a lot of Burberry jackets, that's why a lot of jackets from like St. John and other brands didn't really work for me, or because they have so much extra like fabric on the side. And so for me, I'm obviously flat chested, I'm a guy. And so I decided to get a size small, and it was probably one of the best decisions that I did. And this baby is like chef's kiss. I'm 100% happy with it. Like, this is the coat of the season. When I look at all my coats, I literally look at them, I'm like, you know what, I love all you guys, I'm thankful for all of you guys, but I think this is gonna be a totem coat season, especially with my tote baseball cap. And I'm planning to get a few more totem items later on, and it just kind of goes with my kind of like new aesthetic. I can wear my white Prada runway glasses, which I also got from Farfetch, the totem hat that I got from Farfetch. I can wear them with so many different items, so many different ways. And so that's why I went ahead and went for it. It does have one button snap closure, but I prefer it to be kind of more open. For me, I don't really like to close my jackets unless if I'm actually genuinely walking to my car or walking outside. But for me, it's usually from the car to the building, to the building, to the car. I'm out in the park or kind of like walking around. But for the most part, I tend to wear open, and it is super, super long, and it has a nice slit in the back. And so I finally got my totem jacket, the one that I finally been wanting to get for such a long time. It is finally mine, and I think I styled it quite well. I think it looks phenomenally great. And so for me, this is going to be my what's new in designer, new handbags, new designer items. And like I said, I think all the items that I've been working with Farfetch that have been curated have always been really great items, because I feel like it's wearable, it's usable, it's just not a moment item. They're items that I've been using. So this one, they've all been items that I've been loving and wearing throughout the seasons and throughout since I purchased them. And so they've always been great purchases. I know myself pretty well, so I tend not to buy things that I'm not gonna wear anymore. I feel like that's a mistake that is in the past for me ever since I left Nordstrom. So I think going forward, just in general, whatever I purchase, really, I make sure that it's gonna work for me. And just by the excitement of the totem jacket, the excitement of the bags, the sweatshirt, I already knew because I already had some. I knew that they were all really great purchases. And yeah, guys, that's one of the reasons why I love shopping on Farfetch, just because the shipping tends to be really, really fast. The service is phenomenal. They have a rewards program, and I think that they have quite great prices, because a lot of them are quite, you can kind of compare and contrast prices versus regular retailers here in the States versus Farfetch. Just because sometimes where it's shipping from, the price can vary, and most of the times the prices are a little bit less. And then if you have like a coupon code, it definitely draws it back a little bit less as well. Code, I'll leave it right here. And then also I will be leaving all the great information down in the description box. I want to say thank you so much to my beautiful subscribers for watching this video. I love each and every single one of you. And I will say thank you so much Farfetch for working with me with this video. I'm so excited for everything, and I cannot wait to use them and style them and see them in future videos. So thank you so much guys. I love each and every single one of you, living the gay fantasy through you. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye and take care.